Students, 9th standard science class, chapter matter in our surrounding children. We just finished with the process of evaporation, its definition, consequences that all takes place during the evaporation process. Children, today let us try to know the factors affecting the evaporation. There is a very small activity here wherein we have to take a test tube. Okay, let us take one small test tube, and in this let us fill 5 ml of water and keep this near the window under the fan or under the fan. Keep this test tube which is filled with 5 ml of water, keep it under the fan or near the window. At the same time, take one china dish, fill this china dish also with same quantity of water, that is 5 ml of water, keep it near the window or under the fan. So this is one condition, children, and this is another condition, second condition. Take 5 ml of water in the china dish and keep it in the cupboard. Keep it in a closed cupboard. Leave all the three set up for some days, maybe 3 days or 5 days or something. Later on, try to observe the quantity of water evaporated in them. So what we can observe, children, the water which was there in the surface of the water which was present in the china dish, which had a larger surface area, that means in the china dish there was larger surface area, that means more water could get exposed to the atmospheric temperature, whereas the water which was there in the test tube maybe could not get exposed to the temperature as it took place in the china dish. And the china dish which was kept in the cupboard, the evaporation would have been very, very less. That means the surface area and the temperature, that means climatic conditions, have something to do with the slower or the faster evaporation. So let us see the first condition, an increase in the surface area. Just now whatever activity we dealt with can be a very good example to say that more the surface area, more the evaporation of water. That means surface area is one phenomenon. If the surface area of the container is increased, the evaporation will be more. More the surface area of a container, more the evaporation. Faster the evaporation or more the evaporation. Drying up the cloths can be another example. So that is one factor, children. Coming to the next one, that is an increase in temperature. We all know that in the sunny time, in the summer season, the clothes dry up very faster compared to rainy or the windy season. That means the temperature more, the evaporation also will be more. So during the summer time, the temperature will be more, and this temperature makes the air particles move faster. That means something to do with the kinetic energy. So temperature makes the particles move faster, more of the kinetic energy, better the evaporation process. So that is one thing. So second factor is increase in temperature. The third factor what we have is the decrease in humidity. Humidity is nothing but the water vapor present in the air. So air is a mixture. It contains so many things in it. It contains components like different types of gaseous material, that is carbon dioxide, argon, and all the oxygen, nitrogen and everything, dust particles, it is having dust particle in it, and also water vapor. Presence of water vapor in the air is what we call it as humidity. This water vapor can be hold, the air can hold this water vapor at certain amount of temperature. If the temperature has any fluctuations, there will be a difference in the water vapor present in the air. That means if amount of water vapor, water in the air is already it will be there. If at all it is high, the evaporation will come down. That more the humidity, lesser the evaporation. So humidity in air brings down the evaporation process. This is another factor. We have one more factor, increase in the wind speed. Though there is no temperature in the atmosphere, if the air moves faster, if at all it is a windy day, the clothes dry faster. We have observed it. So when the wind is moving faster, it takes off the water vapor also. So naturally that will help in taking this evaporation faster. So increase in wind speed also helps in more effective on the evaporation process. So it's a common observation that we see that clothes dry faster on a windy day, as I told you, and with the increase in the wind speed, the particles of the water vapor will be moved away. Naturally, water vapor will come down. There will be decrease in the amount of water vapor, leading to a good rate of evaporation. So increase in surface area, the very first factor, children, increasing surface area, that means the container in which we are taking it, increase in temperature, decrease in humidity, and increase in the wind speed are the factors that has something to do with evaporation. Let us see the further part in the coming video classes, children. Thank you.